it's with such a vision to start with. It's a wonderful carousel. It's not just a plain commissioned carousel. This one's unique because everyone put their own personalities in it.
Because there are so many stories involved with the carousel and there are so many pieces of our region depicted, it's more than a 3.5 minute ride.
We didn't have a carousel frame, and when we did find the carousel frame, it came from Bridgeport, Connecticut, and it had sea scenes painted on the rounding boards. It was glorious, very artistic. It had lots of places that we could put art. In fact, there are 106 pieces of original art on that carousel. We have something called rounding boards, which is what goes around the top. I don't know who had the idea. It was a wonderful idea to do the history of Kingsport on those panels.
Some of it was suggestions by some of the carvers and longtime residents of the area, and looking at the whole long history up into the 50s. I did smaller sketches of everything and then enlarged them to this size. We cut out the shape, which is an odd shape of the rounding board. Once the lines were transferred over, then we had some photos to work from and then painted the whole thing.
I was the local point person for artists that needed to work on their rounding boards. They would come to my studio, and if they needed any help, I would help them on it.
Some professional artists, but many of them had done very little painting, and so they did this project as not only a way to participate in the carousel, but to learn.
We all painted together, and people sort of helped each other with ideas for their boards.
They're all done with acrylic paints, and acrylic, when it dries, turns into plastic. So it's very long-lasting, very durable.
It also had clowns all around it on the inside of the carousel, and children don't like clowns anymore. They scare them.
At one point, we knew we were going to do platform animals, and that was great. We knew we were going to do rounding boards. That was fabulous, and it was a wonderful group of people that executed that work. But we had no idea that we would be doing birds.
We talked to our local ornithologist, Rat Cross, and he came up with 24 colorful birds of our area. And different artists painted those. We had artists involved from all over.
They asked me to do the birds, and I felt like I was Alice in Wonderland, just dropping through a hole. The camaraderie between the carvers, their openness with talking to the people and telling about the history and how they put things together. I wanted to give our artists a little bit more freedom to come up with their own composition, their own take on the bird, what they would be willing to do. This was a leap of faith, and you're never sure how it's going to go, and can I totally trust the artist that I have? And I've got to say, everybody who started to do the actual painting on the project completed the task.
Wonderful artists stepped forward, and lo and behold, we have 24 beautiful depictions of area birds that are really colorful, and you can see them in the area, but they're depicted on the carousel. Likewise, our volunteers were working on the project, and they said, these shields need something. Let's put wildflowers on there. We had no idea we'd have wildflowers and different species of butterflies on our carousel, and we do, and it was volunteer directed. What we could not have anticipated was how the volunteers directed the activity. There are so many stories in each piece of art.
We had artists that painted the rounding board scenes. We had artists that did the birds. Then when they came up with artists to do butterflies, local butterflies, on the boards underneath the rounding boards. And then they came up with, well, let's put wildflowers on the button boards. All these different pieces have different types of art on them.
And everybody has their own style and palette. The collaboration of everyone doing their own and then seeing them all together, it's just an incredible work of art.
Now the angel boards, we painted in all different nationalities so that anyone that rides the carousel, there's an angel watching over you. I also did two of the pieces on the ticket tree. I did the little bear, the little baby bear, and then also the squirrel.
I carved two of the sweep animals.
Our carousel, again, is unusual in that we have sweep animals in the sweep area, there's 20 plus sweep animals.
Sweeps are the rafters, and our carousel had all this wonderful space up in the rafters. And there's 23 little animals, birds, flowers up there.
And the rule was you could have a sweep animal if it could crawl or fly to get up on the sweeps.
I carved a little cat up there. I also have a squirrel. And after I finished the squirrel, I carved a flying pig because I had told my husband we'd have a carousel in Kingsport when pigs flew.
From there, I thought maybe we were kind of finished with the carousel. Someone came to me and said, well, you know, we need benches to sit on while people are waiting. So I gathered some artists together and we started painting the benches. So we have some beautiful benches now for people to sit on at the carousel.
It's a joy for not just children. This is not a child's ride.
You can't look at our carousel and look at it and say, well, that's interesting, and walk around it. You need to spend time with it so that you can see all the different parts.
It has become not only a beautiful and wonderful end result, but it's become a community core.
I just want to see that it's maintained with the love and care that has gone into making it. So that way it will be maintained from now and into the future forever.